Hello, in today's session we'll be discussing about the p-block elements. This is the last session of the p-block elements. The topics we'll be studying will be the chlorine, hydrogen chloride, oxo acid of halogens, interhalogen compounds, group 18 elements and xenon. Now, chlorine. It can be prepared by any one of the following methods, that is by heating manganese dioxide with concentrated hydrochloric acid, that is MnO2 with HCl, we get MnCl2 and chlorine with water. However, a mixture of common salt and concentrated H2SO4 is used in place of HCl. By the action of HCl on potassium permanganate. So this is the second type of reaction where we can get chlorine, and this is the first kind of reaction. In both reactions we get chlorine, but the second reaction it is more, in this reaction we get more amount of chlorine. We get by the action of HCl on potassium permanganate, we get KCl, MnCl2 and water. So this is how chlorine is being produced in laboratories. Now, manufacture of chlorine in industries, it is done by Deacon's process, that is by oxidation of hydrogen chloride gas by atmospheric oxygen in the presence of copper chloride, that is catalyst at 723 Kelvin. Or the second process is electrolytic process, in which chlorine is obtained by electrolysis of brine, that is concentrated in HCl solution, where chlorine is liberated at anode. It is also obtained as a byproduct in many chemical industries. So this is how chlorine is being produced. The second is its properties. It is a greenish yellow gas with pungent and suffocating odor. It is about 2 to 5 times heavier than air. It can be liquefied easily into greenish yellow liquid which boils at 239 Kelvin, and it is soluble in water. Chlorine reacts with a number of metals and non-metals to form chlorides. Now, we have seen its color, its odor, its density and the boiling point, that is 239 Kelvin. Chlorine reacts with a number of metals and non-metals to form chlorides. Since we know chlorine is an acidic compound, so it reacts with metals to form salts. For example, it reacts with aluminium to form aluminium chloride. It reacts with phosphorus to form phosphorus chloride, sodium to form sodium chloride, and with sulfur it forms S2SaCl2, ferrous to ferrous chloride. It has a great affinity for hydrogen. It reacts with compounds containing hydrogen to form HCl, that is hydrogen chloride. H2 reacts with Cl to form HCl, H2S reacts with Cl to form hydrogen chloride. And C10H6, that is this is an organic compound, it reacts with an organic compound to form chlorine and carbon. With excess ammonia, chlorine gives nitrogen and ammonium chloride, whereas with excess chlorine, nitrogen trichloride, that is explosive in nature, is being formed. When NH3, this is when the ammonia is in excess, so we get ammonium chloride with nitrogen. And when chlorine is in excess, so we get nitrogen trichloride with hydrogen chloride, wherein nitrogen trichloride is explosive in nature. With cold and dilute alkalis, chlorine produces a mixture of chloride and hypochlorite, but with hot and concentrated alkalis, it gives chlorides and chlorates. With the cold and diluted, it forms chloride and hypochloride, and with hot conditions and concentrated condition is formed chloride and chlorate with water, and with a dry slaked lime it gives bleaching powder. Dry slaked lime, we know calcium hydroxide, with calcium hydroxide it forms bleaching powder. Now, the composition of bleaching powder is CaOCl2.CaCl2.CaOH2.2H2O. Chlorine reacts with hydrocarbons and gives substitution products with saturated hydrocarbons and addition products with unsaturated hydrocarbons. For example, It reacts with methane and the chlorine reacts with methane in UV light to form methyl chloride, that is CH3Cl plus HCl. At room temperature, it reacts with ethene to form 1,2-dichloroethane. Chlorine water on standing loses its yellow color due to formation of HCl and HOCl. Hypochlorous acid, HOCl is so formed, gives nascent oxygen, which is responsible for oxidizing and bleaching properties of chlorine. So when we have chlorine water, that is chlorine gas dissolved in water, it loses its yellow color because chlorine is yellow in color. It loses its yellow color because it reacts with water that is present and forms HCl and HOCl, where HOCl formed gives nascent oxygen, that is only single atom of oxygen which has oxidizing properties. So that is why it is responsible for oxidizing and bleaching properties of chlorine. It oxidizes ferrous to ferric and sulfite to sulfate. Chlorine oxidizes sulfur dioxide to sulfur trioxide and iodine to iodate. In presence of water, they form sulfuric acid and iodic acid respectively. So when FeSO4 is reacted with Cl2, it forms Fe2SO4 whole thrice. It oxidizes the FeSO4 to Fe2SO4 whole thrice. It reacts with Na2SO3 to form Na2SO4. Sulfur dioxide gets oxidized to sulfur trioxide, and then with water it forms sulfuric acid H2SO4. With iodine it forms iodate, and with that iodate, when reacting with water, it forms iodic acid. It is a powerful bleaching agent, as we have seen. We have seen its oxidizing properties. Now we will see how it acts as a bleaching agent. Bleaching action is due to oxidation, that is when Cl2 reacts with water to form 2Cl plus oxygen. This nascent oxygen color substance reacts with nascent oxygen to form colorless substance. That is how bleaching action is being performed by chlorine. Now hydrogen chloride, it bleaches vegetable or organic matter in the presence of moisture. Bleaching effect of chlorine is permanent. Glauber prepared this acid in 1648 by heating common salt with concentrated sulfuric acid. Davy in 1810 showed that it is compound of hydrogen and chlorine. Now preparation. In laboratory, it is prepared by heating sodium chloride with concentrated sulfuric acid. Sodium chloride with concentrated sulfuric acid, it forms NaHSO4 and HCl when heated. And NaHSO4 reacts with NaCl to form Na2SO4, and further HCl is being produced. HCl gas can be dried by passing through concentrated sulfuric acid. Now HCl gas is passed through sulfuric acid, and we get dry hydrogen chloride gas. Now the properties of hydrogen chloride gas. It is a colorless and pungent smelling gas. It is easily liquefied to a colorless liquid which has boiling point 189 Kelvin, and freezes to a white crystalline solid which has freezing point 159 Kelvin. It is extremely soluble in water and ionizes as follows: HCl reacting with water to form H3O plus and Cl minus with Ka107, that is, it is highly acidic in nature. Its aqueous solution is called hydrochloric acid. High value of dissociation constant Ka indicates that it is a strong acid in water. It reacts with NH3 and gives white fume of NH4Cl. When three parts of concentrated HCl and one part of concentrated HNO3 are mixed, aqua regia is formed, which is used for dissolving noble metals, example gold and platinum. Now aqua regia is a special kind of mixture which has three parts of HCl and one part of concentrated HNO3, which can dissolve noble metals inside them. When the jewelers, what they do, they with the help of this aqua regia, they clean the surface of noble metals, gold articles, and the aqua regia. In aqua regia, we get the gold present in them. Therefore, that is how the noble metal articles, that is gold articles, are cleaned. Now what happens, gold and platinum, they form AuCl minus. Since we have three parts of concentrated HCl and one part of HNO3, now this type of reaction occurs and they get dissolved. Hydrochloric acid decomposes salts of weaker acids, for example carbonates and hydrogen carbonates and sulfites, etc. Now what happens is carbonates, they react with chlorine and hydrogen chloride and CO2 effervescence is being produced. Similarly with hydrogen carbonates, the same, and with sulfites, SO2 is being formed with pungent smell. Now the oxo acids of halogens, due to high electronegativity and small sizes, fluorine forms one oxo acid, that is HOF, known as fluoric acid or hypofluorous acid. The other halogens form several oxo acids. Most of them cannot be isolated in pure state. They are stable only in aqueous solution or in the forms of their salts. The oxo acids of halogens are given in the, and their structures are given in the figure. Now this is the table for oxo acid. First is halic acid. Only fluorine forms only halic acid, that is hypohalous acid, that is hypofluorous acid, hypochlorous acid, hypobromous acid, hypoiodous acid. Chlorine forms every type of oxo acid, whereas the other forms only limited numbers. Halous acid, only chlorous acid is being formed. Halic acid is formed by chlorine, bromine, iodine. The structure for all these oxo acids are given. In place of halogen, that is Cl here, we can replace Br and I for the same oxo acid. But chlorine forms all type of acid, so they are, the figure of each is being given here. Now interhalogen compounds. When two different halogens react with each other, interhalogen compounds are formed. They can be assigned general composition as XX', 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 and XX', where X is the halogen of larger size and XX' of smaller size, and X is more electropositive than X'. As the ratio between radii of X and X' increases, the number of atoms per molecule also increases. Thus, iodine, fluoride have maximum number of atoms as the ratio of radii between I and F should be maximum. That is why its formula is IF7, having maximum number of atoms. Now how they are prepared? The interhalogen compounds can be prepared by direct combination or by the action of halogen on lower interhalogen compounds. Now one atom should be more electropositive and another should be more electronegative. So fluorine is the most electronegative element, therefore it will occur with all of the halogens from chlorine to iodine, but iodine cannot form interhalogen compounds. Iodine can form interhalogen compounds with everyone, and so can fluorine, but the same cannot be said for chlorine and bromine. Chlorine reacts with fluorine at elevated temperatures in equal volume to form 2ClF. When excess of fluorine is used, 2ClF3 can be, we can get 2ClF3. This is the maximum number of atoms we can get, since the radii difference between Cl and Fe is not very high. Iodine can react with chlorine to form ICl. Iodine can react with excess of chlorine to form ICl3. Bromine can react with fluorine to form BrF3. Bromine can react with excess of fluorine to form BrF5. Now since bromine and fluorine have larger difference in their radii, so more number of fluorine atom are there in the molecule. Now the properties of interhalogen compounds. These all are covalent molecules and are diamagnetic in nature. They are volatile solids or liquids at 298 Kelvin, except ClF, which is a gas. Their physical properties are intermediate between those of constituent halogens, except that their melting point and boiling point are little higher than expected. Their chemical reaction can be compared with individual halogens. In general, interhalogen compounds are more reactive than halogens, except fluorine. This is because XX dash bond in interhalogen is weaker than XX bond in the halogen, except FF bond. All these undergo hydrolysis, giving halide ion derived from the smaller hydrogen or hypohalite when XX dash halide, when XX dash 3 halate and XX dash 5 and parahalate when XX dash 7, that is in case of iodine and fluorine. Anion derived from the larger halogen, that is XX dash plus H2O forms HX dash plus HOH. Their molecular structure are very interesting, which can be explained on the basis of valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. The XX3 compounds have the bent T shape, XX5 have square pyramidal, and IF7 has pentagonal pi pyramidal structures. Now, the more electronegative element, that is X dash, which reacts with hydrogen, and the less electronegative element, that is X, will form hypohalous acid. Now, the group 18 elements. Now, group 18 elements consist of 6 elements, that is helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. All these are gases and chemically unreactive. They form very few compounds. Because of this, they are termed as noble gases. Now, occurrence, all these noble gases except radon occur in the atmosphere. The atmosphere abundance in dry air is 1%, by volume, of which argon is major constituent. Helium and sometimes neon are found in minerals of radioactive origin. Example, pitch blende, monazite, clevite. The main commercial source of helium is natural gas. Xenon and radon are the rarest elements of the group. Radon is obtained as a decay product of radium. That is 2 to 6 radium forms 2 triple 2 radon and helium. Electronic configuration, all noble gases have general atomic configuration NS2 NP6 except helium, which has 1S2. Many of the properties of noble gases, include their inactive nature, are ascribed to their closed shell structures. Due to stable electronic configuration, these gases exhibit very high ionization enthalpy. However, it decreases down the group with increase in atomic size. Atomic radii increases down the group with increase in atomic number. Since noble gases have stable electronic configuration, they have no tendency to accept the electron and therefore have large positive values of electron gain enthalpy. The physical properties, all the noble gases are monoatomic. They are colorless, odorless, and tasteless. They are sparingly soluble in water. They have very low melting and boiling points because the only type of interatomic interaction in these elements is weak dispersion forces. Helium has the lowest boiling point, that is 4.2 Kelvin, of any known substance. It has unusual property of diffusing through most commonly used laboratory materials such as rubber, glass, or plastics. Helium can diffuse through all these materials, rubber, glasses, or plastics. This is a very unique property of helium, with very lowest boiling point, that is 4.2 Kelvin. The chemical properties, in general, noble gases are least reactive. Their inertness to chemical reactivity is attributed to the following reasons, that is, the noble gases except helium have completely filled NS2 NP6 electronic configuration in their valence shell. They have high ionization enthalpy and more positive electron gain enthalpy. The reactivity of noble gases has been investigated occasionally ever since their discovery, but all attempts to force them to react to form the compounds were unsuccessful for quite a few years. In March 1962, Neil Bartlett, then at University of British Columbia, observed the reaction of noble gas first. First, he prepared a red compound, which is formulated as O2 plus PTF6-. He then realized that the first ionization enthalpy of molecular oxygen was almost identical to xenon. He made the efforts to prepare same type of compounds with xenon and was successful in preparing another red color compound, XII plus PTF-. By mixing PTF and xenon, after this discovery, a number of xenon compounds, mainly with most electronegative elements like fluorine and oxygen, have been synthesized. The compounds of krypton are fewer. Only the difluoride has been studied in detail. Compounds of radon has not been isolated, but only identified by radio tracer technique. No true compounds of argon, neon and helium are yet known. So xenon, since it forms compounds, so we'll gonna study xenon. Xenon fluoride compound, xenon forms three binary fluorides, XCF2, XCF4, XCF6 by the direct combination of elements under appropriate experimental conditions. Xc plus F at 673 Kelvin, 1 bar pressure forms XCF2 with xenon in excess. When 1:5 ratio, Xc and F2 at 873 Kelvin at 7 bar pressure, XCF4 is being produced. At 1:20 ratio, that is 1 mole Xc and 20 moles fluorine. At 573 Kelvin, 670 bar pressure, XCF6 is being produced. XCF6 can also be prepared by interaction of XCF4 and O2F2 at 143 Kelvin when oxygen is being liberated out. XCF2, F6 and F4 are colorless crystalline solids and sublime readily at 298 Kelvin. They are powerful fluorinating agents. They are readily hydrolyzed even by traces of water. For example, XCF2 hydrolyzes to XCFCF and O2 with the following reaction. The structure of three xenon fluorides have been deduced from VSEPR theory as shown. XCF2 and XCF4 have linear and square planar structure respectively. XCF6 has 7 electron pairs, 6 bonding, 1 lone pair, and would thus have distorted octahedral structures to form as found experimentally in the gas phase. Xenon fluoride reacts with fluoride ion acceptors and form cationic species and fluoride ion donors to form fluorine ions. The following reaction, where M can be any metal of the following choices. Now these are the xenon oxygen compounds. Hydrolysis of XCF4 and F6 with water gives XCO3. The following reaction, XCF6 will gives oxyfluorides. These are the structures of the fluorine compounds. XZO3 is a colorless explosive solid and has pyramidal structure. XZOF4 is a colorless volatile liquid and has square pyramidal molecular structure. So this is XZF6, this is XZF2O, XZOF4 with one lone pair, square pyramidal structure. This is XZO3 with one lone pair. So this is the end of the session and end of the chapter. E block elements, that is the 7th chapter from NCRT textbook. For more information, log in to Webcoach, and you can refer from NCRT class 12 textbook for further information. Thank you.